Hello everyone. Now this is the video for class 8 student and here we are going to discuss creating a database chapter. Now before going to the details of the chapter, we have to understand what is database. Basically, database is a collection of organized data. As we know that raw fact we cannot store. We need some processing of the raw fact to make it information. Now that information we have to store in our machine. Now how can we store the data in our machine? There are some way. One is flat file concept. I will make a file, I will store it in my computer. Like that way I can store 100 of files in my computer. But the problem is whenever I'm going to search for a file, it will be a hectic job for me to find the appropriate file. Now, another way is I will create a table where I will store the information. Like if I want to maintain the entire information of students, what I will do? I will create a database where their columns will be like roll number of the students and name of the students, section of the students and the class of the students. Can be a normal database where I will put all the information of yours and I can maintain it very easily. If I want to edit some student name or say if I want to add some more students into this database, I can do this task very easily without having any kind of error in it. Now, MS Access is a software. MS Access, like Microsoft Access, is a software which are going to give you the environment where you can create your own database. Except MS Access, we have few others database software like Oracle we can use, like MySQL we can use. But in this video, we are going to discuss about MS Access only. It is a Microsoft software which we are going to use. I think the concept of database is clear to you. It is a table kind of format where you can store your data very easily. Now, MS Access is the RDBMS. Full form of RDBMS is Relational Database Management System. It stores data using multiple tables. Now, let's come to the concept of multiple tables. Now, say as I have told you, I have made a table for my student information. Like all the students' personal information is not with me. I have only the class name, I have only the roll number, I have the student name and maximum of his or her phone number I can have with me, but each of the students have few personal information like his or her parents' name, address, phone number, location. These all are the personal information of that specific student. So for each student, we have to maintain two separate tables. One table is for its professional information or for school information only. Another table we will use for his or her personal information. Right. So we can create more than one table in a DBMS and we can link both the table. So whenever I will search for say the student number ABC, so I will get his or her all the details like school details, in which class he or she is studying, in which subject he has, or his or her roll number, or else his or her parents' name, phone number, address, everything I will get if I can link both the tables. That linking is called RDBMS, that Relational Database Management System. Now the extension of our MS Access file is .accdb. The older extension was .mdb. Now it is .accdb. Whenever you will create your own database and you will try to store it in your computer, the extension of the file will be .accdb. And the name, whatever you want to give to that file, you can give. I think the basic concept of MS Access is clear to you. Now let's come to very basic points, that components of a access. That tables, like as I have already told you, whenever you are going to create a DBMS, you have to create few tables. Like as I have given you the example that a student table and a student in personal information table. That are tables. Now each table have some field. What are the field? The column names of each table are called the field. Like in case of student school details, roll number, class, student name, phone number, all the columns are the field. Now records, each of the row are called the record. Like whenever I'm going to add a student details, I will add everything. His or her roll number, I will add the class, I will add the section, I will add the student name, I will add everything, I will add the entire row, I will create. That is a record. So table is the entire table where you can create your DBM database. Field are the column of this table. Records are the row of this table. Data sheet and forms. That is the basic entire DBMS. Data sheet is the basic entire DBMS. Now filter and queries. Filter and queries means say I want all the information of the student, those whose names start with S. So I have to put the query like this so that it will get sorted and it will just filter the name of the student which name starts from S. Am I clear? Like if I want all the students' names start with S, so what I have to do, I will put the query like that way that it will just filter the names which starts from S. And after creating the name which starts from S, it will show you all the details of that student whose name start with S. And this is called the report. That entire filtered data is called the report which we want from the computer. Now let's start with MS Access. After downloading MS Access, how can we start? We'll go to the start menu button, we'll click on that and your MS Access is ready to go. Now after clicking on MS Access, this kind of page will come. Now you have few options to create your DBMS. You can create a blank sheet, you can create, you can use your templates also. Now here, I am not going to get details of the templates right now. I'll explain it everything. But here what I am trying to discuss, that after clicking on the Access 2016 or whatever version you are using, that kind of page will come where the blank DBMS will get selected and clicking on that it will going to open. Now see here, you can create your DBMS by using predefined templates. As I have already told you, there are few other templates are already available. You can use the predefined templates. You can even create your own templates too. Now how can we click on the predefined templates? Now what I have to do, I have to go to file, I'll go to new, and then after I'll get this. Even in this, I got the templates over here. Clicking on each of the template, I will be able to open the templates format. Now what is templates? The template is kind of like, if I want to create a student database, it will of course not going to match with the employee database. Of course the field name will be different. If I want to create a student database, the field name should be different if I want to create an employee database. So templates are a basic templates are those which the regular person use in our life, so that are available. So clicking on that, you can use a predefined templates. Now what I have to do, after I go to the new, I have to click on the sample templates, and then after I have to press on the create button and it will going to create. Now if you want to open your existing template, in that case you have to browse it from over here. You will click on that, it will going to give you an option to choose which file you want to access, and after that you will press the open button and it will going to open your existing database. Right? Am I clear? Like, you can create your own database just by clicking on the blank database. You can create a predefined template. You can use a predefined template. You can use your own existing DBMS file just by browsing the file from your device, and then after you have to press the open button and your database is ready to access. Now here you can edit the file. Now data types are over given, but I will explain each of the database in the upcoming slides only. So I'm not going to get into the details of data types. So here I am just trying to tell you that it is the existing database you have. You can edit the database. You can delete an entire row. You can even add an entire column into it. Everything you can do, and after that you just have to save it. And how to save it, that also details I'll come. Now if you create a blank database, then that's very clear. You have to go to the new and you will click on, instead of clicking on any of the predefined sample, you will click on directly blank database. So what it will do, it will create a blank database. Now you have a blank page. Now you can create your own database. After clicking on the blank database, it will going to give you your own blank page where you have to create your table. You have to put the data by your own and you have to save it by your own only. Now, creating of DBMS has two types. Datasheet view. You can create your table in two views. Datasheet view and design view. You can create your table in two ways. Datasheet view and design view. Now in datasheet view, there is a predefined table exist. Like, you cannot change the entire frame of the table. You can only add something. You can delete something, you can edit some data on it, but you cannot change the entire structure of the table. So when you need to create a quick table, like just few change and you are ready to use your database, then you can use that data sheet view. How to do it? You, after opening, you will go to the data sheet view, you will go to the add new field. Or else there is another option, add existing field. Now here I'm going to add new field. See, here you can add your new field. Here you can just add your new field where table 1 is already exist. Now if you want to add one more table, you just have to add one here. You just have to click over here. It will going to create another table and you can add your table over here. There is not an issue if you want to even add a table on your database. So what is the meaning of datasheet view? In case of datasheet view, you are not able to create the database from the beginning. There is an existing database. You can only edit the existing database. You can only delete something from it. You can edit something on it. You can, like, add some few features to it, but you cannot delete it entirely. But if we want our own, then we have to use design view. If we want our database to be our, like our own database, where some, everything will be mine, everything, every name given to the field will be my choice, every information will be given to it will be my choice, we have to use design view. Now in that case, you have to add field name. That means the column name, each column has a data type that I'll discuss on the upcoming slides only. I think in the next slide only I'll discuss that thing. And the description of, like, say if I think of a simple field name like roll number, then the field name, in case of field name, I will put roll number. In case of data type, I will put number, as roll number is a number type data, only a number. It cannot be a fraction only. It will be only a number. Then after, I will put the description that it will maintain the student roll number, or like it will maintain a student details uniquely. That will be my description, what I want to put in the description box. That can actually, the purpose of description is to show the purpose of each of the field. Right. So, in case of design view, if you want, here you have to create your own table. You have to create everything by your own. So, you have to put all the details. In case of a table, you have to put each of the field name, each of the field data type and the description. Now, a few types of data type. First is short in. Short in basically range from 0 to 225. That details I am not going to discuss over here. Like a short in is like my roll number, which can vary from 1 to 35 to 40 maximum. It is short text. You can use short text. Sorry, it is short text only. So, in case of short text, you cannot do it. Short text is like, in case of gender, it will take either female or male. So, what I will put either F or M only. So, I have to put only a single character. So, I can store it by using short text. In case of data type over here, in case of data type, if the field name is gender, then in case of data type, I can put short text. Now, long text can be used in case of name, where the name of every student cannot be of same size. So, in that case, we have to use long text. Date and time, the joining date of the school, it is a date and time type of data type where you can put the date directly. Now, currency, it's very clear. Currency of each of the country are different. So, you can add different type of currency by using that currency data type. Now, auto number. Auto number is something which will generate by its own. Like in case of roll number, it will generate by its own. If I have roll number 1, I should have roll number 2, I should have roll number 3. Like that way, it will generate by its own. You don't have to put the roll number. It will create its own. I will just put the name against of the roll number. Next is number. That is also very clear thing, that number we can put in case of mobile phone number. Then phone number, which is a big number, in that case I have to use number type data type. Now hypertext. If I want to put a hypertext, like a link or something on my database, I have to use hypertext type data type. Now boolean is like 0 and 1. If it is, it will take either yes or no. Like for a student, if I maintain a details whether he has passed from class 7 to 8 or not, so the answer will be either yes or no. There is no in between of yes and no. In that case, I can use boolean. I think it's clear, but still I am going to discuss it once again. That short text is something which we can use if the text size is very small. In case of gender, it is either male or female. So, we can use that short text. If I want to use only a few characters, like 2 to 3 characters, then we can use short text. In long text comes when we have to put the whole name of the student. That the size of the name varies. So, in that case, we have to put long text. Next is date and time. Date and time we can put if we want to add something which is related to date, year, month, like the joining date of the student to the school. Now, currency is what kind of data type, what type of data which will add different types of currency of different type of country. Like a student studying in India will use rupees, a student studying in USA will use dollar. Like that way, it has different type of currency. Now, auto number is something which will generate the number by its own. If I have added 1, it will next number will be 2 only. You cannot change it. It will generate by its own. So, auto number is something which we can use in case of roll number only. Because in case of phone number, we can't use. The phone number will not generate 1 by 1. We all have separate different phone number at all. So, we cannot use auto number over there. In case of roll number only, we can use auto number. Next is number. Number is a type of data type which we can use in case of phone number, which we can use in case of like driving license number in case of our Aadhaar card number, that we can use number type data. Next is hypertext. If I want to add some hyperlink to my document, like to my database, then I have to add that hypertext data type. Next is Boolean. Like Boolean is either yes or no. See, if the answer is either yes or no, there is no in between, in that case we can use. Like if someone passed from class 7 to 8, the answer will be either yes or no, as I have told you earlier. Then in that case we can use Boolean data type. See, it is a design view. Here field name you have to give, field data type you have to give, and the description you have to give. Everything have to be given by you only. There is no one else will maintain your table. You are the only owner of that table. You have to make everything from the beginning. Now, the setting of a primary key. What is the concept of primary key? Let me just discuss it with you. The primary key is something which can separate us data, which can separate a record from the other record. Now, let me explain it even more clearly. Like two students can have the same name in our school. It is very common that in a class two students are having the same name. But how will I separate them? Even if the title is also same, how will I separate them? We can separate them by their roll number. If one of them is having roll number 5, the second one cannot have the roll number 5. Second one should have the roll number 6 or something else. So, by using that roll number only, we can separate two students absolutely. So, that primary key is something by which we can separate two records. Right? So, you have to choose your primary key very like thinking of all the field. You have to choose your primary key. Like if you choose your primary key wrong, your table will not going to work properly. Now here is the field size property. Now if I have already given a field name, say name, by default it will be shortened. See, if all the data type is given as shorted. So, if you want to change it, you have to just click on it, or you have to click on the general button, and you here will get the field size, and here you can put the field size. Like by default it is 255 characters. I want it something more, or else I want it something less. So I can put the field size over here. Right, so if you want to change the field size, so you can go to the field in which you want to change. After clicking on that, you will get this, and on the general tab you will click and you will get the field size. Here you can change it. Now next is saving and closing a database. It's very clear to you. It's available over here in the saving option. Clicking on that, it will ask for the table name. You give the table name, and after that you will press the OK and it's done. You will go to the saving option, then after it will ask for the table name, and after clicking on the table name, it is done. It is saved. Now you have created your own table. You have saved your own table. Now the next task is left is adding the record to your table. After saving the document, what I have to do, I will open the table again by clicking on the access, and then after I have to go to the open option. I'll choose the file in which I want to edit, and after that it will show me this page. And there it may possible that your database are having more than one table, say 5 to 6 tables. Then what I have to do, in which table I want to add the data, I will click on that. See here, that yellow one is already selected. Oh no, there is only one table. It may have, there are few others table. So if you want to add the data on a specific table, you will click on it. Now after clicking on that, you will get all the field name. You will get all the field name, and you got everything. You can add you can edit your document over here. You'll just have to write as we write in an Excel sheet. The way we used to write in an Excel sheet, you can write it over here, over there. Now, this is your data sheet view as I have told you earlier only. And you can see how many records are already saved. And if there is any error, like in case of phone number, I have given my name, then it will not be able to store, because phone number is a number type data and name is a text type data. It will not going to match, so it will show you an error. That everything you can do by just on this page. You don't have to go anywhere else. You just add all your document over here, and then after you will save the document once again. Now, I think the concept of access is clear to you all. If you have any question, you can ask me on this channel. And now, for now, bye. We will meet on the upcoming chapter very soon. Thank you for watching the video. Stay happy, stay healthy, stay at home.